All right, and BJP President Amit Shah met Prime Minister Narendra Modi to finalize the members of the Union Cabinet in a five-hour-long meeting on Tuesday, 2 days ahead of the swearing-in ceremony of the new government. With the Prime Minister's second innings as the Prime Minister, the big question arising now is who will make the cut for his cabinet? There are too many conjectures, in fact, viewers, that are floating around the place as to who will make the cut for the cabinet, but we will only know when the swearing-in takes place. The biggest suspense looms over Amit Shah's inclusion in the cabinet, whether or not he will get a portfolio or will he be taking care of the party affairs. As per the reports, Amit Shah might be given a berth in Modi's cabinet, but if that happens, he will have to resign as the party president and a new party chief will have to be appointed. Finance Minister Arun Jaitley may opt out on the back of health reasons, although he is reportedly on the road to recovery, but the possibility of a reshuffle cannot be ruled out. Earlier, when Jaitley fell ill as well, Piyush Goyal worked as a finance minister and also presented the interim budget. Questions also loom on whether Sushma Swaraj will continue as the external affairs minister. She did not contest the Lok Sabha election, citing ill health. So a lot of questions right there, and of course the suspense continues. And despite a bit of war of words, West Bengal Chief Minister Mamata Banerjee has confirmed that she will attend the swearing-in ceremony of Prime Minister Narendra Modi. Mamata's decision to attend the swearing-in ceremony of PM Modi comes at a time when the BJP has claimed that several TMC leaders will desert the party to join them. In fact, we did see a lot of councillors, in fact 50-odd councillors joining the BJP from the TMC yesterday as well. Hours after Mamata confirmed attending the ceremony, Aam Aadmi Party Chief and Delhi Chief Minister Arvind Kejriwal also confirmed that he will be attending. Rajnikanth has also confirmed that he will take a break from his film shoot to attend the oath-taking ceremony. Invites have been handed over to Kamal Haasan, Jagan Mohan Reddy and KCR. Leaders of Bangladesh, Sri Lanka, Bhutan, Thailand, Myanmar and Nepal will attend Modi's oath-taking ceremony. The President of Kyrgyzstan and the Mauritius Prime Minister have also been invited. But in a strong message from the government, the Pakistan Prime Minister Imran Khan has not been invited. President Ramnath Kovind will administer the oath to Prime Minister for a second term as the Prime Minister. The ceremony will be taking place at Rashtrapati Bhavan on 30th May at 7 p.m. The crisis in the Congress, that is what we're tracking now. The Congress is facing a leadership crisis after the dismal performance in the general elections. Rahul Gandhi, who is adamant on stepping down, has been persuaded to remain the party president for the next 4 months. Rahul is given the working committee 4 months' time to find a replacement. The Congress Working Committee, or the CWC, meanwhile, has authorized Rahul Gandhi to make structural changes and rearrange the organization for strengthening the party. Sources have informed India Today that Rahul has put his foot down on his resignation, saying that it is non-negotiable. Rahul has reportedly accused the CWC of bullying him into continuing as the Congress president. Meanwhile, many leaders within the Congress and outside have appealed him to not take that drastic step, stepping down as the Congress party president. Party leaders, including Priyanka Gandhi Vadra, Randeep Surjewala and Ahmed Patel, rushed to Rahul Gandhi's residence to try and convince him to stay on as the party president. In fact, our consulting editor Rajdeep Sardesai also spoke to senior Congress leader Abhishek Manu Singhvi on this particular matter. Hear into what Abhishek Manu Singhvi had to say.
Dr. Abhishek Manu Singhvi, what are we to interpret what's happening in the Congress? Does Rahul Gandhi want to stay? Does he want to buy time? Or does he simply want to opt out and you're not letting him go?
Knowing Rahul Gandhi as I do, to my limited extent, I would say that he is utterly resolute. He's not the kind of person who doesn't mean what he says, and I don't think he wants to continue. I think, of course, he may continue for a month or 2 months, but he doesn't want to continue, is very clear to me. Having said that, I am personally of the opinion, and Rajdeep, I am speaking today not as a Congress spokesperson, but in my capacity as a congressman. I personally believe that he should continue, and I say it for the reason that it would be playing into the hands of the BJP. These are dire straits, these are adverse times. There is no press button mechanism. Everybody who tells me, have a change of leadership. Can the same person I ask the question, do you have a ready solution and alternative? Nobody does. Not one single person.
Meanwhile, Congress leaders are unhappy with Rahul Gandhi's decision to quit and have requested him to stay back. Let's listen into some reactions that are coming in from the Congress party as well.
2014, when everyone wrote off the INC, it was Rahul Gandhi who fought back and made INC relevant again in 2019. It is not just the question of the Gandhi family. It's a family, parivar of the Congress party. And the Gandhi family is part of that. And you know, that is why Congress needs him, country needs him. The destiny of the party and also the destiny of the country lies in the hands of Rahul Gandhi.
Congress mein koi aisa shaksiyat nahi hai jisne ye kaha ho ki hum isko swikar karte hain jo Rahul ji ne kaha ki wo resign karna chahte hain. Humne sabko usko nakara aur jo CWC ki meeting thi usme badi spashtata se keh diya ki humme se koi isko accept hi nahi karega.
Amidst the coalition crisis in Karnataka, Congress leaders Ghulam Nabi Azad and KC Venugopal are in Bengaluru. Azad and Venugopal will be meeting top leaders of the party in the state, followed by discussions with the party MLAs in order to iron out any differences and ensure that no leaders switch camps. Ahead of the big meeting, state Congress leaders Siddaramaiah and Dinesh Gundurao met with Chief Minister H.D. Kumaraswamy on Tuesday night. Leaders from both the Congress and the JDS are rebelling against the alliance, speaking out publicly against each other. This even as the BJP seeks fresh polls calling for Kumaraswamy's resignation. Remember, JDS's Gauri Shankar had said H.C. Devagowda would have won the Tumakuru seat with a margin of more than 2 lakh votes had they not been in alliance with the Congress party. Another JDS MLA, Srinivas Gowda, confessed that he backed the BJP candidate from Kolar as opposed to the Congress candidate. On the other hand, Congress leader K.N. Ranjana claimed that the coalition government of JDS and Congress will collapse after the 10th of June.
Sarkara biddo bo yuvagle biddo godu 30 tarikhavarege eno modi
nam devagoudrige maiti ilde hogide 7 lakh vote al gelisodu na yuvagi hottide kumaranadan bayadru parvagilla devagoudrudanna pakshinu aachadru parvagilla namge ee maiti samasya bedagilla
helbekadru helbekadru avalla mani kashta billilu adu gelisalikke gelisalikke ಗೆಲ್ಸ್ಬೇಕು ಅಂತೇಳಿ ಇಡೀ ಕೋಲಾರ ಕ್ಷೇತ್ರ ಅಂದರೆ ಎಂ ಪಿ ಕ್ಷೇತ್ರದಲ್ಲಿ ಎಲ್ಲರೂ ಪ್ರಯತ್ನ ಮಾಡಿ ಯಾರು ಒಬ್ಬರೊಬ್ಬರು ಎಮ್ ಎಲ್ ಎಗಳು ಕೂಡ ಎದುರೆಲ್ಲ ಬಹಳ ಕಾಯ ವಾಚ ಮನಸ ಎಲ್ಲರೂ ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾಡಿ
ಗೆಲ್ಸ್ಬೇಕು
ಇವ್ರನ್ನ ಗೆಲ್ಸ್ಬೇಕು
ಮುನ್ಸಾಮಿನ್ ಗೆಲ್ಸ್ಬೇಕಂತ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಜನ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ
ನಾವು ಮಾಡಿರೋದು ಮುನ್ಸಾಮಿನ್ ಗೆಲ್ಸ್ಬೇಕು
ಟಾರ್ಗೆಟ್
ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ವಾರದಲ್ಲಿ ಜೀರೋ ಟ್ರಾಫಿಕ್ ಜೀರೋ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ ಯಾವ ತರ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಜೀರೋ ಆಗ್ಬೇಕು ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಏನಾಗ್ಬೇಕು ಸರ್ಕಾರ ಬಿದ್ದೋ ಇವಾಗ್ಲೇ ಬಿದ್ದೋಗೋದು 30 ತಾರೀಕವರೆಗೆ ಏನೋ ಮೋದಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಪ್ರಮಾಣ ವಚನ ತಗೊಳ್ಳೋವರೆಗೂ ಏನು ಮಾಡೋದು ಬೇಡ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿ ಅವ್ರ ಪಾರ್ಟಿ ಒಳಗಡೆ ಇರೋ ನಿರ್ಣಯ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಅಂತ ಯಾರು ಹೇಳಿದ್ದಷ್ಟೇ ನಂದಲ್ಲ ಆದ್ರೆ ಮುಂದಿನ ತಿಂಗಳು 10 ತಾರೀಕು ಒಳಗಡೆ ಮ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಿಮಮ್ ನಾನು ಹೇಳು ಇವ್ರ ಸರ್ಕಾರನೂ ಇರಲ್ಲ ಇವ್ರ ಜೀರೋ ಟ್ರಾಫಿಕ್ಕು ಇರಲ್ಲ ಜೀರೋ ಟ್ರಾಫಿಕ್ ಜೀರೋ ಅವತ್ತಿನ
You see, you know very well, we are 177 assembly conscience, we are number one place. Out of 25 Lok Sabha constituencies. Better if they dissolve the assembly and go for fresh elections. For that, we'll welcome.
Our next step is, in Karnataka, there is a unhealthy government is there. Anti-people, anti-farmer government is there. This government should go and Yediyurappa ji should come back as a chief minister of Karnataka and we should serve the people of Karnataka because they have elected us. It's a record winning 25 seats plus one. We won for BJP, that's why we want to serve for the Karnataka and also for India.
Massive forest fires have been reported in Chamoli, Uttarakashi, Tehri and Bageshwar districts as temperatures soar in the state of Uttarakhand. Fire has engulfed forests in Garhwal district while Chamoli and Tehri are the worst hit districts. The blaze has been raging on for the last few days and efforts are now on to control the forest fire before it spreads out of control. You can take a look at the visuals that are flashing across your screens right there. Temperatures have also risen in the districts on the back of forest fire. The Met Department has now issued an orange alert predicting 3 to 4 degrees Celsius rise in the temperature in the state of Uttarakhand. Pilgrims are also finding it very difficult to breathe because of the smoke that is emanating from the fire. Forest officials have said that deficit rains and an increase in temperature is also to be blamed for the rising incidence of wildfires. The authorities are now trying to ensure that there are no casualties on the back of the raging fires as well.
कि जंगल की आग का धुआं है इससे काफी परेशानियां हैं धमाके मरीजों के लिए बड़े बुजुर्गों के लिए और आंखों में जलन होनी अभी स्टार्ट हुई है और अभी हमारे सामने के पहाड़ हमें थोड़ा धुंधले नजर आने लगे हैं चार धाम यात्रा इस समय चल रही है उसे देखते हुए वन विभाग को भी ठोस कार्रवाई करनी चाहिए
धुएं की वजह से नीचे उतरना पड़ गया इससे ज्यादा परेशानी और क्या हो सकती है लेकिन ये मेरे ख्याल हर साल ही कोई ना कोई इसमें प्रॉब्लम आती है तो ईश्वर से प्रार्थना है कि बारिश हो जल्दी से ताकि ये प्रॉब्लम भी सॉल्व हो जाए जल्दी से जल्दी
कि जंगल की आग का धुआं है इससे काफी परेशानियां हैं धमाके मरीजों के लिए बड़े बुजुर्गों के लिए और आंखों में जलन होनी अभी स्टार्ट हुई है और अभी हमारे सामने के पहाड़ हमें थोड़ा धुंधले नजर आने लगे हैं चार धाम यात्रा इस समय चल रही है उसे देखते हुए वन विभाग को भी ठोस कार्रवाई करनी चाहिए
Thanks for watching the video. For more such news and updates, please like, share and subscribe to India Today. Also check out our other great videos from our channel, We Know You Will Love To.